just wait. Nobody, and I do mean nobody, messes with the Mighty Pete.
So, Mighty Pete, who lives in this tower anyway?
Oh, you don't know, eh? Well, it's old Yen Sid. Of course, he's probably a heartless by now.
Master Yen Sid lives here?
Yen Sid is the king's teacher.
Wow, sounds powerful.
Go, 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 go!
Seems Pete doesn't seem too amused. This is ignoring him. Ah, this world and I shouldn't. Never mind. Freaking, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, I really shouldn't talk about Dream Drop Distance. I'm pretty sure there's a lot of people who still haven't played this game, and I don't want to have anybody get a void of playing this game or watching this Let's Play because I spoil that game. So I'm not gonna spoil that game through this Let's Play, maybe through my Kingdom Hearts 1 Let's Play, but as for this Let's Play, I'm not going to talk about anything whenever it comes to Dream Drop Distance, because I don't want to spoil anything for you guys. All I can really say is that I really loved the music, and the game was fantastic, seriously. Square's doing a fantastic job. It's just that, I don't know, like I said before, it's just, it doesn't really have that Kingdom Hearts 2/1 charm to it, you know what I mean? I don't know. But it's still good, no matter what. I really enjoyed the game.
Pretty good!
I think the only thing I didn't like about Dream Drop Distance, though, is the lack of extra bosses. That's one thing I liked about Kingdom Hearts games, is the fact that they had hidden bosses. Like, they did have one, but that was it. And then plus you get to, like, do the other things with the other bosses and stuff like that. But other than that, there wasn't really any secret bosses. Like, well, not enough, though. But then again, it is on the 3DS, so it's like, can't have too much in the game. We'll just give you a little bit. So it's like, okay. That's pretty good. By the way, if anybody doesn't know, in Kingdom Hearts 2, the Final Mix games, not just Kingdom Hearts 2, but Kingdom Hearts Final Mix games, they recolored some of the Heartless, or actually all of the Heartless that they could recolor, because, actually, I don't really know, to be honest. I couldn't tell you.
Heartless, Heartless, Heartless. Kids haven't changed one bit.
Well, it's a good thing we're on the job then.
So, the worlds aren't at peace after all?
Oh my, the worlds aren't in peace anymore.
I don't know why I'm talking like that. But anyways, we're almost there. We're almost to Yen Sid. Oh, of course they make us fight one more set before we get to see Master Yen Sid.
Of course they would!
Oh wow, we're getting these dark shards and stuff like that. Those will be important for later on. But for now, they're not important.
Master Yen Sid, it's an honor.
Hey there.
Sora, show some respect.
So, you are Sora. Now then, have you seen the king yet?
Yes, we did, Master, but we didn't get a chance to talk to him.
Yes, the king has been quite busy of late. Therefore, it would seem that the task of instructing you three falls upon my shoulders. You have a perilous journey ahead of you. You must be well prepared.
You mean, we have to go on another quest? I was looking forward to finding my friend Riku, so we could go back to the islands.
Yes, I know. However, everything in your journey, Sora, is connected. Whether you will find your way home to the islands, whether you will return alone or with your friend, and whether or not the islands will still be there. And the key that connects them all is you, Sora.
I'm the key?
Chosen wielder of the Keyblade, you are the key that will open the door to light. This book contains valuable knowledge you will need for your journey. Study it carefully. Once you have finished, we will speak of the enemies you will surely confront.
Alright, cool. Alright, let's open this chest. What's it gonna give me? Can't really remember. Oh, it's just the map. Alright, Tower of the Map. Cool. Alright, let's read the book. The beginning. The beginning. Each journey gives rise to chance encounters. Chance encounters. Oh, God, oh my gosh. Those chosen by the light. Fuck me, guys. I'm not even gonna try to fucking read it, cause you know, fucking can't read for the life of me. The fucking. I just wanna read the fucking. Okay! Okay! Fucking skip! Gee! What's wrong with you? Interlude! Ah. Wow, what was that weird noise? A long dream. Okay, stop. Oh my gosh, I'm so horrible. I'm such a horrible person. Alright, this is cool stories.
Yeah.
The future story. Be not afraid, entrust your body to the soothing waves of your memories. By and by, your fleeting rest will be over, and everything will begin. Oh my god! No more. It's time to fucking. I need to stop this session soon. Fucking. God dang!
But wait a sec. How come the Heartless are still running around?
Your past endeavors did prevent an immense effusion of Heartless from the Great Darkness. Make no mistake about that. However, the Heartless are darkness made real, and darkness yet lingers in every heart. The Heartless are fewer. But while darkness exists in a single heart, it will be difficult to eliminate them.
Gorge, that must mean if everybody's heart was full of light, them Heartless would go away.
Now, it is time to speak of the enemies that you will encounter. If one such as you, Donald, yields to the darkness in their heart, they too will become a Heartless. But you know this. The Heartless are always lurking and ever seeking to capture new hearts. Never let your guard down. Now then. At times, if someone with a strong heart and will, be they evil or good, becomes a Heartless, the empty shell they leave behind begins to act with a will of its own. An empty vessel whose heart has been stolen away. A spirit that goes on even as its body fades from existence. For you see, no bodies do not truly exist at all. No bodies may seem to have feelings, but this is a ruse. They only pretend to have hearts. You must not be deceived.
No bodies. They don't exist.
Now then, the being you see before you is known as a Dusk. They are the most common form of nobody. But there are others, some larger, some with frightening and unique powers. Be vigilant. On your journey, you will meet an alarming number of Dusks. They will all attempt to do you harm. Still, they are nothing but empty shells destined to return to darkness. But the beings you see before you now are different. These powerful nobodies have formed a group called Organization 13. It commands the lesser nobodies.
Organization 13.
While Heartless act on instinct, nobodies function in a higher manner. They can think and plan. And it seems they are working towards a goal. What that goal is, we do not know. The king sensed the danger and journeyed forth to fight it. He found the Dark Realm's keyblade and with it closed the door. Now he's traveling from world to world, fighting the Heartless as he seeks the answer to the riddle of the nobodies and Organization 13.
Then I guess we better go find the king first.
But where could he be?
Well, we won't know till we look.
Yeah, and the king must know where Riku is, because the two of them were together in the Realm of Darkness when we closed the door. You know, after defeating Ansem.
So, before you go, you will need more suitable traveling clothes. Those look a bit too small for you. Through there, you'll find three good fairies. If you ask, they'll create for you appropriate garments.
Gorse, Sora, you sure are growing fast.
I guess.
Sora's growing old!
Me, you guys, Riku, and the King. I don't care who this organization is or what it's planning. With the five of us, I mean, six of us, there's nothing to worry about, right?
Yeah!
All right, whoa. It's starting off as a game. Oh, I thought it was going to make us do a cutscene sort of thing. Okay. Wait a minute. Aren't there stickers in this game? What the heck? Anyways, let's talk to the Red Fairy. I don't really know their names because I don't remember watching Beauty and the Sleep as a child, but I do remember as saying, I don't even care, but whatever. I'm pretty sure they're from Sleeping Beauty.
Well, look who's here, dears. Sora, Donald, and Goofy. Oh, if you're looking for clothes, you've come to the right place.
I'll do the designing.
Oh, that will never do. Oh, now, dears.
But don't you like this better?
Hold on.
Are you certain?
Blue.
Would you just decide?
All right, then. Together now, dears. And no more squabbling. Oh, my.
Oh, it's lovely.
Oh, yes. He does look very dashing. Now, those aren't ordinary garments.
They have very special powers. Take the orb, dear.
And watch what happens.
Wow!
Whoa!
Wow!
Two keyblades!
This journey's going to be twice as difficult as your last.
The garments also have other powers. But you'll have to discover what they are as you continue on your journey.
Okay, I'll do my best, and thanks a lot.
Oh, and there's something else for you from Master Yen Sid.
All right. And there's Valor Form. And this is another reason why I chose Critical Mode. Because, as you clearly seen, Critical Mode has that ability where you don't level up whenever you defeat enemies. I want to use that whenever I want to level up my other forms, so that I don't level up myself, you know what I mean? So that I stay the same level. Because I don't want to become too overpowered while I'm training these abilities. Or maybe I will. I don't know. Whatever. The drive command has been added. The gauge on the lower right is consumed for transformation. Cool. Yep. So now we got that drive thing in the lower right corner, as it said. And every single time we use our drive forms, or drive form, we turn into that form. Now, see, the thing is, when we use that, in the cutscene it didn't show this, but when you use Valor form, it takes Goofy off of your team, and then it turns you into that. So it's sort of like that. You take the other friend's powers and turn it to your own. Sort of thing like that. I don't know why they did that, but I guess they had to make some kind of concept. Sora, you dropped something. Huh? Or, Yep. Now, these are stickers, or puzzle pieces, if you want to call them. I call them stickers or puzzle pieces, whatever. And where is it? Or I think he just automatically grabs it. But these things, you just got to put them together once you collect all of them, and then it turns into something good or something not so good. I will be collecting them after the Let's Play. Like, I'll show the locations, so I'm going to try to avoid them. Or maybe I will collect them throughout the Let's Play, but I just don't want it to be, like, really weird for everybody who's actually looking for all of them. But whatever. Never mind. I'll just collect them as we do the Let's Play. Fuck it.
tiny ship.
So, you guys ready to go?
Now, now, just a moment. Because of your previous endeavors, the worlds have returned to their original states. That means the pathways between them have disappeared.
How do we get around?
Do not fear. If what the king suspected proves true, the worlds have prepared new pathways along which you may travel. These pathways may be utilized by unlocking special gates. How these gates are opened, I'm afraid I do not know. However, the Keyblade will serve as your guide. When a beam of light radiates from the Keyblade, return to the gummy ship. Though the worlds may seem far apart and out of reach, they nonetheless remain connected by invisible ties, as do our hearts.
Our hearts are connected.
That is correct.
Got it.
But be warned, as you proceed, the Heartless and the Nobodies will be using their own paths. Corridors of darkness to travel from world to world. They may be attempting to link these dark pathways to the gates between the worlds.
Hey, that's not fair.
Now then, that is all the information I can give to you. Go forth, Sora, Donald, and Goofy. Everyone is waiting.
Okay, let's get going.
Master Yenson!
We sure do appreciate the help.
My goodness, what's that? Haven't we seen this somewhere before?
Yes, dear. I wonder whose it was.
Oh, Malefa!
No, we mustn't remember her name. Oh, dear.
She was a mean old witch. Oh, no. The memories are coming back. What'll we do? Oh, what'll we do?
Goodness,
Perhaps we should tell Master Yen Sid.
Yes, that's what we must do. Hurry.
Maleficent!
Yeesh. She sure does enjoy being resurrected.
Howdy, Sora. How you doing?
Yo, what's up, dude?
It's your favorite gummy engineers here, ready for duty, Chip. And Dale.
Yeah.
Happy flying.
Cool. Alright, there we go, guys. Yes, Sora, only one.
That's no good.
Why?
Wait, I think it's a world we know.
Really? Blah, 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 blah. Anyways, guys, I'm going to call it the session here. Like, it's over. Like, the introduction session is over now. Like, we're finally finished. I really hope you guys are enjoying this so far. I'm trying the best as I can to keep this entertaining, but, I'm just going to upload these parts, and then I'm not going to do any of the Let's Play. I'm going to finish uploading these parts just so that I can see what you guys have to say. and I'll gather up everything that you guys want me to do, and then I'll continue the Let's Play. So, yeah, I'll see you guys in the next session. Thanks for watching. I love you all. And bleh.